Hey, this is Dana White from the UFC, and you're watching ProMMANow.com.
Hey, guys, Dan the Wolfman for ProMMANow.com with the beautiful Misha Tate. How's it going?
Good. Did you interview Kat Zingano?
Yeah, so don't hate me. I've been a little hard. People have said I've been critical, but what I've been critical of is not you. Let me clear this up. What I'm critical of is...
I know.
So I thought this would be good. But I'm not critical of you. I'm just critical that UFC's been setting a precedent lately of someone coming off a loss getting a championship fight. Now, as Kat explained to me, you know, it was a number one contender fight, and since she's injured, you get it, so I understand that. I didn't mean any disrespect towards you at all. I hope you understand that. I'm just calling it like it is. Yeah. Either way, I'm sure the drama that you and Ronda will create on Tough, and especially on Fox Sports 1, launching it is going to be good for the sport and is going to be good in overall. So I understand that.
Yeah, you know, my point on it is I agree with you. Typically coming off of a loss, I think is really stupid to, like, have someone come in and fight for a world title off a loss. I've always been pretty vocal about that. You know, at the same time, though, I can say that I felt like the fight with Kat was really, really, really competitive, and I won the first two rounds. And I know that she won in the third round, but I feel like the stoppage, you know, in my opinion, it was a little bit controversial. However, she definitely does deserve to be here, but she is injured, like I said, and it's not like she, you know, handed my ass to me, you know what I mean? I felt like it was a really, really good fight. And
yeah, as a fighter, athlete, you got to take any opportunity that comes your way. I've said the same thing as Chael. I'm friends with Chael, but I was against him fighting Jones.
Right.
So, what do you think of kind of the almost, you know, the disrespect that Ronda kind of shows to not even acknowledge you as a fighter that's been in the game longer than her, that's fought for titles before her, that's, you know.
You know, just I just think Ronda has a really big head. You know, she's incredibly talented and she's great at what she does, and I give her all the props in the world for being good for this sport and bringing women's MMA to the next level, you know. But I think having that certain amount of, like, humble understanding is what's going to help me get to the next level. I still feel like she has a really big head, and I think that she so has her head in the clouds about everything that she's done. You know, she's not giving anything back, you know, any recognition back. She's always been very disrespectful to me from the very beginning, before she was ever anybody. And I do believe in karma, you know. Mm-hmm. I believe it'll come around to bite her in the butt.
I'm the one who asked you the question about that she's given up the back. I mean, she has given up the back in the last couple fights, so.
Well, I'm sure she's, you know, I'm sure we're not the only person to notice. I'm sure she has and her camp has as well, so I would expect that she's going to be working to adjust that. So, I don't know. You know, we'll see what the fight brings. It is definitely a weakness that we've observed,
Did you start training with Dennis Holman as well, or were you involved with him in the past?
No, I was involved. I trained with him for almost 2 years.
Okay.
Yeah, he's kind of helped get me into strike force.
He's got his first fight back in a while coming up. So, what do you think of all this when the fans are screaming for Ronda? And
it's great because she doesn't have that much more to fight.
Do you think it's kind of more the media push being behind her? I mean, obviously she's good with armbar, good with her judo, but do you think it's more that she's getting pushed out there as the face?
Yeah, I mean, she deserves it, though, because she's the champion, you know, and I'm just glad that women's MMA is getting that recognition, and I feel like the bigger she is, the bigger I'll be when I beat her.
How's the cupcake business coming?
Well, I have no business right now. I just love to eat them, so.
Are you going to do that when you retire? Are you really going to maybe
look at it? Yeah, I would love to do it, I think, you know, but we'll see what the future holds.
Thank you for the time. I appreciate you letting me explain myself.